war of just bombs and guns to kill flesh and destroy blood. But it's a deadly battlefield for cultural souls.
Hey, hey, oh, no, 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 yeah. One of the biggest thing about countering terrorism is how you perceive it, because your perception leads to your response. The traditional perception is criminality in war. So what naturally follows, you need kind with kind to justify the stars. But with a more modernist approach of cause and effect, a more asymmetrical result you will get. Hey, terrorists will never win. Terrorists will never win in no part of the earth. In no part of the earth. Terrorists will never win. Terrorists will never win in no part of the earth. In no part of the earth. Terrorists have adapted to the modern global world, and so we must do too. So those who are working and counter responses should put on their Google tinted glasses and whatever else can do. We've got to have interactions, reach out to terrorist constituency, show some better options. We've got to practice what we preach. We must eradicate ignorance, injustice, and poverty. We've got to engage, educate, and have dialogue. Terrorists will never win. Terrorists will never win in no part of the earth. In no part of the earth. Terrorists will never win. Will never win in no part of the earth. In no part of the earth. So if your intention is destruction, you know that's wrong. Not a part of the plan. Destroying the plants, animals, and human. There's got to be a better resolution. A life must go on, regardless the plans of Babylonians. The spirit of life, I know it must rise above your destructive weapons. Yeah. Terrorists will never win. Terrorists will never win in no part of the earth. In no part of the earth. Terrorists will never win. Terrorists will never win in no part of the earth. In no part.